Are you sick and tired of being sick and tired? It's been said that an apple a day keeps the doctor away, or does it? I was feeling so bad. I asked my family doctor just what I had. It's time to get a new prescription for your life. Get ready for your daily dose of Healthy Talk Radio, the show that's empowering your health. And now, here's America's health and lifestyle coach.
Live. Do you want to get well? This is a show where your health is your wealth. Thriving is more important than just surviving, and the only thing lost are those unwanted pounds. I'm your health and lifestyle coach, and this is Healthy Talk Radio, from heart disease, aches and pains, to even your basic cough and sneeze. This is talk radio that's empowering your health. Thanks for joining us. Phone lines are open, 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. Or you can always send me an email. We are your prescription for change. Kick it off now with Suzanne. Hi, Suzanne.
Thank you for taking my call.
Sure, darling. How can I help?
Well, I got a lot going on. I'm going to be 54 this year. And I went on disability here a few years back because I had to have a joint replacement, and I got something called reflex sympathetic dystrophy. Do you know what that is?
Sure.
Oh, okay. And so then I moved to Kentucky. I wanted to go see you last weekend, but I have to work. I work with racehorses. I went off disability and I started working. And I have high cholesterol. When I came here, I was on like really heavy pain medication, like morphine and Percocet and Soma and Valium and everything. And I got off all that, but I still have to take pain medicine. And I was on the Neurontin, and I stopped that for the RSD. I take lovastatin for high cholesterol. I've developed high blood pressure, and I take lisinopril, and I have to take ketan, and then I still have to take pain medicine and Valium, which I want to find alternative things to take instead of taking narcotic medication. I also have two bulging discs and a pinched nerve in my back, scoliosis and curvature of the spine, so I'm trying to think of ways. I'm not overweight. I walk. I mean, like I said, I work with horses now, and I'm trying to think of alternative ways, and I'm going to buy your book tomorrow, weekend when I'm off, and see about a new diet. But I'm trying to think of alternative things to all this medication that they want me to take.
I know, and that's a lot. And with you having not only RSD, but also having other issues, especially that's going on with like your blood pressure.
And I'm bipolar, and I've taken every medication out there, from lithium, Depakote, Topamax, Risperidol, Abilify, everything, and I can't take any of it, and I can't take any antidepressants because they work adversely on me. As soon as I take them, I get the side effects of the muscle rigidness and stiffness, and I have to stop them immediately. So it's pretty tough.
It is tough, Suzanne, but at the end of the day, you got to step back and say, okay, it's not about what I can't do, it's about what I can do. So let's come up with a game plan. And really, with RSD, it's a challenge because technically they say there's no cure when it's, you know, there's chronic pain like it is, and it shows itself all over. I mean, it can show itself anywhere.
And I have fibromyalgia real bad, too.
Well,
I have osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis.
Is there anything you don't have?
I don't know. I got quite a bit going on, but I'm still trucking along. I mean, I'm in pretty good shape, physically. I work, like I said, with horses. I'm at work right now, and I walk for 13 hours in and out of a truck, and then I do foaling for 5 months of the year where I deliver racehorse babies and stuff. So, I mean, I work really physical work.
Have you done,
with all this going on.
In the middle of all this, have you done any physical therapy? Have they looked into that for you at all?
Yeah, I did physical therapy years back when I first went on disability. But since then, I haven't done any. I go to a hot pool, and when I get a chance, a therapy pool. And I also do psychotherapy where I talk to a psychologist. I've been talking to him for like 10 years, and he's taught me a lot of meditation techniques and stuff that help a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know what I can take. You had mentioned the other night, I listen to your show every single night, and like I said, I really wanted to go to your show. You mentioned something about a pain medicine, and I can't remember what it was because my mind does race quite a bit,
That's okay.
Alternative to, like, I'd like to try something other than the hydrocodone.
Well, and that's pretty strong medication. But with when you're in the level that you are, Suzanne, with everything that's going on, you have to kind of step back and look at where you are. And I really think there's a good place you can get to. I do. I don't think you're just stuck forever and to be miserable and in pain. Now, the one thing you got to do, the first thing, you're going to buy the book, which is good. You're going to start changing your diet, changing your lifestyle habits, and that's important. So it's good that you're active. It's good that you're already doing things that bring health to your body, such as staying active. But it's going to be important that you put the right things in your body, and that's what the book's really going to teach you. The book Empowering Your Health is really going to show you about foods. It's going to talk about certain supplements that are very good for you. I would say to stay on top of your blood work. That's going to be important to see what kind of nutritional deficiencies you have, what type of levels that you have, keeping the good, and when you find things that are bad, we can build that back up. But the foundational four, that's always a place to start. That's a good whole food multivitamin, digestive enzymes to help break down your foods, cod liver oil for your omega-3 fats, your vitamin A, vitamin D. And then, of course, also the cod liver oil is going to help lower down inflammation in the body. And then probiotics. Probiotics put the good bacteria back in your digestive tract. And really 4 in the morning on an empty stomach, 4 in the evening on an empty stomach is a great way to go. Because literally we've taken so many antibiotics for so long that the probiotics are really great at helping restore the digestive tract and getting your body. Because when that gets restored, then everything else really gets back into play. All right, that's step one. Now, brain chemistry. And did I say brain chemistry? Because with you being bipolar, or diagnosed with bipolar, that plays a big role too. Now, I know you've been on lithium, you've been on all the different medications, that's great, but getting your mind where it's remotely balanced is going to play a big role in all of this. Dopamine is one of the big neurotransmitters with bipolar, and getting dopamine balanced is going to be a key for you. It's going to be a key in you feeling better, a key in your mind being right, just a big key to your overall health. Ways to do that, there's several foods. Meat, such as red meat, organic, of course, fish, salmon, spinach, and also dark chocolate. Dark chocolate has been shown to really make a difference in dopamine levels, but that's 75% cocoa or more. So it's not the actual milk chocolate. Obviously, that's the one you want to stay away from because of the high sugar content. But the dopamine levels that are raised up from chocolate, very beneficial. Supplements that are great for dopamine, too, L-tarine is one. Vitamin B6 has two different versions. One is pyridoxal 5-phosphate, or P5P. That's the one you want to go with. And then finally, when you're looking at dopamine levels and getting those balanced, you want to look at N-acetylcysteine, NAC. You can go to your health food store and just ask the person there. But N-acetylcysteine plays a big role too in getting your dopamine balanced. Now, the pain medication you're talking about that's more from a natural side is white willow bark. But here's the deal. I mean, hydrocodone, that's powerful stuff. I mean, it really is. So you're going to want to work with your doctor on that. I mean, something like white willow bark can add to it, and the only hope that you can have with that is to be able to back down a little bit on the medications. Here's the good news, that when you have so much inflammation in the body, which you do, and you're eating the wrong kind of foods, if you have been for a long period of time, which most people that deal with chronic pain, they really don't have that great of a diet. And so when you change that, literally about 30% at least of your pain symptoms can begin to subside. And that's really substantial. I mean, my gosh, most people say I'll take 2% if it'll just change. So, I mean, that plays a big role. So, I mean, that's something that you're going to want to really get into. And as you dive into empowering your health, you can call and ask questions on the show if you need to, or email me. But the good news is that you're on the right path. And I'm glad that you're seeking out ways to be better, to get better, and to live better. You want to get well, and are you willing to do what it takes?
To find out more, connect with OnCall Radio online at InShapeNetwork.com.
I'm your health and lifestyle coach. You're listening to the show is Diagnosing Hope, one caller at a time. Lots of people jumping on our Facebook, becoming a fan there. Jump on board. You can jump on board there. Also, for all the behind the scenes of what's happening here with the show, our TV show coming up. But it's exciting stuff. That's at twitter.com. Check us out on the web, all the social media. Stay in touch. It's a lot of fun. A whole new world out there now. It's a blast. So we can stay connected with all of you, and we can all interact with each other in our world. It's a lot of fun. So check us out, twitter.com and facebook.com. Let's go now to Ken. Hi, Ken. Welcome to the show, man.
Privilege to talk to you.
And likewise. What's up?
Hey, I just started listening to you, friends at work. I work second shift and part of third shift, and I got a little problem. I'll try to make it quick. I'm trying to get my weight down, and I'm about 6 foot, and I'm about 270.
Okay.
And at one time I was 295, and I've come down, but anymore it seems like I'm so tired all the time. I'm just having such a hard time with the way I work, 10 hours a day, 11 hours, and then, you know, I don't eat the right food. I just started listening to you. People at work are talking about you heavily. And so I got your number, and I thought I'd give you a quick call, and I just started listening to you recently.
Well, that's great. Well, welcome. Welcome to being a listener. You know, I'm already going to applaud you. I mean, you've already dropped 20, 25 pounds just on your own, so that's great. So now we just got to get you down to your fighting weight, which is, what do you want to get down to, what, 185, 190?
Oh, God. I would love to be there. I don't know if I can. I would love to be down there, you know, if I could ever get down there, then that'd be wonderful.
Hold on a minute. Welcome to the show, because the one thing I'm not going to let you do is think, I don't know, I sure would like to. You can't have that kind of thinking. You got to decide right now if that's where you want to be. So is that where you want to be?
Yes, sir.
All right, sir. So first thing that has to happen with anything with your health, and really anything in life, but let's talk about your health. If anything in health, you have to decide that you want to get well. You have to decide what you want, define what that is, write it down, and we focus on it. So number one, obviously, is to have better health. But you need to lose weight. You need to get down to your fighting weight so that your body can function better. So your weight that you're going to shoot for is 185. And we're not going to settle for anything less than that. So there's the goal. Now, you set your weight that you want to be at, which is, that's a fair weight. That's not extreme, and that is a good weight and height for you. So what we'll do now is let's carve out a plan. The plan that needs to happen, and there's the 7 health prescriptions. These are the 7 things that you need to start following to a T to get your health where you want it. And I'm going to go through them with you right now. Number one is you want to get a copy of my book, Empowering Your Health. You can get it at any bookstore, Barnes & Noble, Borders, all of those. And you want to start following the anti-inflammatory diet that's in the book. So that's your starting point. We are what we eat, just like grandma taught us. So that's first and foremost what you want to do is get started on the diet. First thing, because you got to eat. You only change when you start changing what you put inside your body, period. Number two, health prescription number two, is to make sure you get your blood work done every 6 months with your primary care physician. And here's why. Because life is in the blood. Power is in the blood. When your blood changes, you change. Every 90 to 120 days, we lose blood cells. They die off, and we get brand new red blood cells that are made. So based on the foods and lifestyle choices that we make every single day, is going to determine the kind of blood cells we're going to have and ultimately the kind of health that we're going to have. So blood work is very important. Get to your primary care physician. Get blood work done every 6 months. Now, number three, health prescription number three is to follow the foundational four supplements. That's a good whole food multivitamin, digestive enzymes to help break down your food, cod liver oil for your omega-3 fatty acids, and probiotics. Probiotics, you've heard of antibiotics before. Probiotics put the good bacteria back in our digestive tract so our body can function well. And those are the four items that we don't get in our food supply. No matter how organic it is, no matter what the label it is, no matter what brand it is, doesn't matter. Our soil is just not what it used to be in America. And so these are the four supplements that add into our foods the things that we're lacking. Those are the foundational four. Number four, health prescription number four, is you want to exercise 30 minutes a day, 5 days a week, doing something you enjoy. Don't care what it is. Ride your bike, run, jog, walk around the block, work out with weights. I don't care. Just make sure you do it. The body was designed to move. Number five is water. You want to hydrate yourself. Our body was made of 75% water. So our cells need water. Matter of fact, when you get thirsty to that point, you're already about 3 hours dehydrated. So you need to get started drinking a lot of water, half your body weight in ounces. You weigh 260 pounds, 130 ounces of water every single day. And yes, you can do it. That's not tap water. Make sure it's purified, bottled, something like that. Now, the other, number six, is to rest. Our resting is so important, and it's not being lazy, it's planned rest. Because when you work all the time, your body has to have one complete day of rest where you at least get away from the main stressors of life. Hang out with your family, put the cell phone down, put the computers down, and just hang out and relax. And then also your sleep that you get at night. And I know you work a different shift, so you're going to have to come up with what's good for you. But the rule of thumb is that every minute of sleep you get before midnight is worth 4 minutes after. But your body's probably on a little bit different of circadian rhythm, so you got to work with that. Number seven is to go see your primary care physician every 6 months. No matter what, don't care if there's nothing going on. Just let them, even if you meet with them for 15 minutes and they say everything's cool and everything's doing great, you just need to make sure somebody's overseeing your health, not you and not Dr. Google. Okay? Thanks for the call. Thanks for being a new listener. We're always here for you.
This content is brought to you by our good friends at Liberty HealthShare, the absolute best alternative to traditional health insurance. Visit Liberty HealthShare at libertyhealthshare.org.
To find out more, visit the show online, InShapeNetwork.com.
Lines are open this hour, 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. I'm your health and lifestyle coach. You're listening. That show is Diagnosing Hope, one caller at a time. What are you struggling with right now? Diabetes, heart disease, arthritis, fibromyalgia, you name it. Let's talk about it. 8 million of our young people right now are taking psychotropic drugs. Unbelievable. Some need it. Some, it's a little bit crazy to be taking that much. 750,000 people this year will die of cancer. 800,000 will die of heart disease. What do you think about that? Want to talk about it? I think it's staggering. And it's all about the front lines. It's not about waiting till the body breaks down and then, oh, I guess we need to do something about it. It's about education. It's about learning what to do to keep your body healthy. Remember, the body regenerates every single day. Now, that's the hope that we have. The hope is that if our body regenerates every single day, and each day old cells die off, new cells form every single day, then we can make radical changes in our health and get radical results that we're looking for. But are you willing to change? Are you willing to make the change? That is the key. And that's what we're here to do on this show. It's here to educate you, equip you, empower you, enable you to make better choices, because you can. And you may need to take Lipitor for a period of time for cholesterol, but once you get it down, there's a lot of other options and things you can do if you get your lifestyle in a place where it will make a difference. Same is true with blood pressure. Same is true with arthritis. Same is true with losing weight and getting your body where it needs to be. I mean, hey, that one's not that hard. Get your hormones balanced out. Eat less than the calorie output that you put in during the day, and you'll drop the weight. Duh. That's what we do here. Let us be your second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, eighth, tenth, 20th opinion. Whatever it needs to be, we're just a friend, listening ear, somebody here to bounce ideas off of and to help, because really your health is your greatest wealth. I want to give a little shout out down in Birmingham, Alabama, 101.1 The Source, all the team down there. We just want to give you a little hello, let you know we're excited to be a part of the family down there. And one of our closest friends over there in Knoxville, Tennessee, AM 760 WETR, David Wells and all the team. Just want to give you a little hello. And we're loving you over in Knoxville, 888-283-7272. Make sure to check us out, Facebook and Twitter. Get in the social media scene. So get ready. A lot of fun stuff happening. Let's go to Bart right now. Hi, Bart. What's up, man? How can I help?
Yeah, thanks for taking my call.
You got it, buddy. What's up?
My wife has been having some problems with her arms pulsating at night to the point of being so painful she can't sleep.
Okay.
They've tested her for heart problems, circulation problems. They've also tested her for neurological problems. Neither one does she have. What they've told her is something called thoracic syndrome.
Right.
Looked it up on the web, couldn't figure out really any reason or what it really was. So,
and she hasn't had any treatment yet, right?
No.
Okay.
Just tests.
Just all the tests. Now, the pulsating, let's talk about it for a second. It goes down both arms or just one mostly?
Both arms.
Both arms. Only when she lays down at night?
A little bit during the day, but it's a lot worse at night.
All right. But everything she's had done has been negative.
Correct.
She exercised?
Just a little background. She's 49, runs about 6 miles every 2 days, and has not an ounce of fat on her.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, health-wise, she's as healthy as can be except for this problem.
There's three sides. I totally get where you're going with the whole thing. I know it's frustrating. Both of you probably are scratching your head. Doctors are scratching their heads, and everybody's scratching their head, nobody's getting any better.
Exactly.
So here's the deal. The body has three main areas. You got the mental side, that's your brain chemistry, neurotransmitters, subconscious mind, all right? Then you got the chemical side, that's your brain chemistry, but also your body chemistry. And so you've got how your heart, liver, lungs, kidneys, how all of that functions. And then you've also got the structural side, bones, muscles, nerves. And you can even throw arteries and veins in there, and as far as the structural aspect of that and how well they function. You have to look at the body as a whole. That's preventative medicine. That's integrative medicine, looking at the body as a whole. Now, is it true that she could have a thoracic outlet type issue that's going on and causing the pulsations? Absolutely. But there's several things that could be going on. Obviously, she's very fit, and so that's a good thing. But what I would look at doing is I would actually go see a DO, that's a doctor of osteopathic medicine. Here's why.
Okay.
They work with several things. Matter of fact, osteopathic medicine was founded on the principle, the whole field of medicine was founded on the principle that an artery, it was the vertebral artery, which is the base of the skull, but they founded it on the principle that an artery could be restricted by one of the spinal structures.
Okay.
It could restrict arterial flow. So in thoracic outlet syndrome, there's the potential for there to be restricted flow. Now, it can be nerve-related or artery-related. Okay, so that's why they're calling it that thoracic syndrome. And that's the one thing you want to look at in that is to get that, kind of nail it down of which area. I mean, obviously the pulsation is going to show more toward the arterial side, but everything, getting everything healthy in her body is important. And even though she exercises, that's great. But if she's not eating the right kind of foods, getting equal amounts of lean protein sources like chicken, fish, beef, or eggs, and low glycemic carbohydrates in the form of fruits and vegetables, all those sorts of things, and the healthy fats, then her foundation's going to be off. And that's what you want to start with. So get that done, see a DO, and let me know. That kind of rhyme. But stay in touch with me. Send me an email. Thanks for the call. 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. You can also shoot me an email. Now we're going to go to Kathy. Hi, Kathy.
Yes. Hi. Thank you for taking my call.
Of course.
I was kind of like one of your previous callers. I have so much wrong with me, I don't even know where to start. But
today's a brand new day.
I have multiple sclerosis, and I was diagnosed in 1986. Previous to that, I was a big basketball player, and I never did sweat. And I got married when I was 21, and on my wedding day, I woke up with numb, tingly feet, and it was all up my whole body and lasted for about a month. Those symptoms I've never had. I still have tingling sometimes, but nothing like that. So they say that, you know, I've really kind of had MS since 1969. But in 1974, I had a severe whiplash with my son on a tunnel slide. And they never really told me that it was whiplash or what it was, but I would do at-home traction, which really just kind of saved my life, because when my neck would go into spasms, I would do that over-the-door traction, and it would just relieve the tension. But and I did that for 20 years, and but when the MRI finally came out and was available, they diagnosed MS in 86. And no one really concentrated on my neck because they said that goes with MS. And finally, you know, the pain was just so bad. In 96, they took an MRI, and everybody went ballistic because I have 4 bulging discs in my neck and 1 in my lumbar, and I have stenosis and spondylitis. So I have a pretty compromised spine, plus I have MS. And but I always just say I've been diagnosed for 24 years, because that's actually when the MRI found the lesions. But I have had not the normal type. I have not had remitting relapsing. I didn't progress very fast. I'm still walking. I have swam like an arthritis class or some sort of class up to 3 days a week for 23 years.
That's great.
So I've been in the water.
That's great.
And maybe that's why I'm still walking. I don't know. But
it is one of the main reasons.
Do what?
It's one of the main reasons.
Yeah. I think you're right. But my problem is, my drop foot is so bad that I've used an AFO off and on for all the, you know, at least 20 years. And I don't know if you're familiar with the NES L300 for people with strokes and MS with drop foot. Are you familiar with it?
Yes.
Electrical stem. And
that
has just done tremendous things for me. It has helped me so much. And I was just at the neurologist today, and we moved here from Little Rock 3 years ago. So the doctor in Little Rock had measured my leg, and it had atrophy so bad that it was like 4 inches smaller than my other leg.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to go into this commercial break, and when we come out, we're going to talk about MS, and we're going to talk about the drop foot that you're talking about right now, Kathy, because there's a lot that you can do, and I know you're getting to the point where the leg's getting a little bit more withered and things aren't working the way they need to, but let's talk about some ways to come out of that, especially in dealing with multiple sclerosis. So hang on. 888-283-7272.
On-call radio and watch on-call TV at InShapeNetwork.com.
Lines are open this hour. 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. I'm your health and lifestyle coach. You're listening to the show. It's Diagnosing Hope, one caller at a time. Going to the break, we were talking with Kathy. Kathy's been struggling with MS for a long time, 23 years. I believe that's right, Kathy. And now you're getting to a place where you have drop foot, and it's getting kind of to the point where things are withering a little bit, and the foot's just not working hardly at all, right? And you're wanting to figure out what to do?
Right. But I've had drop foot for probably 18 years, but it's just really getting bad.
Yeah.
I've worn an AFO for all those years.
Oh, okay. I'm with you. So is that your main question, is what to do with the drop foot? Is there anything
to
get out of
that? No, my main question is this neurologist that I saw here in Nashville is the first one of many, many, many neurologists, I would say probably 12 or more. And he tested me for spinal cord injury, and I do have spinal cord injury from the whiplash.
Mm-hmm.
And it just helped clarify a lot for me, because my MS has been so different than most people, because it's been so very, very gradual. But I have tried so many alternative programs and spent so much money, and I really can't tell just a whole lot. And I'm on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 medicines. I'm not doing any of the MS medicines anymore because I've had it so long. But I was just wondering if, you know, there might – I haven't read your book, and I'm
That's
sure,
okay.
You know, I'll get that and read that. But I just wondered if there was any alternative things that I could be doing that I haven't done. I know that I was very low on magnesium, mm-hmm. and so I was taking a lot of magnesium, and I took MSM. But like I said, it was very costly, and so I don't know.
I know it put you in a place. I get it. And I know you've been around the block, been around almost like the merry-go-round with everybody, and with multiple sclerosis, with MS, first things first is don't call it yours. That's the first thing I heard you say. It was my MS, my MS, my car, my dog, my husband. You're my husband, not my husband, my wife, my dog, my car, my kids, all those kind of things are great. Those can be yours. But when it comes to a disease, don't ever let that be yours. It can be the multiple sclerosis, but not yours. Just because you've been diagnosed with it doesn't mean that you have to hold on to it or keep it. But it's true. Remember, the mind is very powerful. And so when you think about when you're dealing with MS and you're in a place right now where you're saying, okay, I'm watching actual parts of my body begin to decline. You've got drop foot and you've been dealing with it since you're 18, or for 18 years rather. And you're in a place right now where you're saying, I need something. Something needs to change in my body. Well, the one thing that can really change within you is you. And I know you've sought treatment and you've sought all these things, but I think what now is a good time to kind of regroup. And I can tell you some things that are helpful, and I really can't. And the key is, I think it's amazing that you've had the mindset that you've had to just push through in certain areas. You're going to exercise. You're going to make it happen. No matter what, you're not going to give up, and that's good. But let's come to a new place. Okay, now things are going to be really focused on, obviously, what you're putting on the inside of your body, but it's going to be more of a well-rounded approach. And that's what you're going to find when you read my book. It's very balanced, and you've got it talks about the different aspects of the body, different sides of the body, and how everything works together. Because in the body, one thing does affect the other. And that's a pretty neat thing that you're going to begin to see and find out. So with MS, we found a couple of things. Now, one big one is cholesterol. And we found that in cholesterol, the good cholesterol, which is the HDLs, you know, the high-density lipoproteins, the HDLs, when you keep those elevated, matter of fact, the higher you can get them, say, in the 60s, 70s, or 80s range, then they found that the MS symptoms can begin to decrease. So they found a direct correlation with the HDL cholesterol and how it affects MS symptoms. So that's one thing to focus on, and you get that from the good healthy fats. You also get it from high levels of what's called nicotinic acid. Now, that's not niacin. It's a version of niacin, but it's not like taking regular niacin. You won't get the flushing effect and everything, but nicotinic acid is fantastic. Keeping your fats up to at least 40%, 35 to 40% of your diet will be a key. So that means you got to keep your gallbladder healthy. You got to keep your acetylcholine levels, which is a brain chemical. It's one of the number one neurotransmitters in the brain. Keeping that healthy, because that helps break down fat. Believe it or not, it triggers the gallbladder to actually help emulsify the fats in the body and break them down. The more you can break down fats, the better you can utilize fats to make things like hormones and to support different chemical processes in the body. So those are a couple of things that you want to focus on. Bile salts will be good to help the gallbladder, glycine and taurine. And the more you can utilize your fats with MS, the better. So those are just a couple of things to get started with. I would look into staying on top of your blood work. Don't just go with it and just kind of, you know, just get it done maybe once a year. I would do it every 6 months. And I would look for vital key nutritional deficiencies. I would also encourage you to stay on top of that cholesterol. And I know you're just taking several medications, and I think that's good. But make sure you have a good physician that you're working with, someone that you really trust, to kind of be your head coach through it all. And get a copy of the book, Empowering Your Health. And if you have questions, we'll dig in from there. I just want to give you a little bit. I'm running toward the end of the show right now, so hang tight. Get a copy of the book, and you stay in touch with me either on the show here by calling in, or you can always email me, and we'll always be here for you. Puts another hour in the charts. I'd like to thank our producer, Jay Patrick, John Garrison, Leslie Pardue, and the rest of the team. I'm your health and lifestyle coach. Go tell one person something you learned on this show, and together we can change the health of our friends, our families, and our communities. You're listening to the best in healthy talk radio, where we're diagnosing hope one person at a time.
This show is designed to provide accurate information of a general nature on the subject matter covered, and given with the understanding that neither the host nor the station is engaged with rendering any form of medical advice, diagnosis, or treatment. This information is not approved by the FDA and is not intended to diagnose, prevent, treat, or cure any disease.
To experience more of Asa Rx Audio, visit us at asarx.com.